Windows is like your house. To prevent hard-to-clean dirt over time, basic maintenance is essential. Hence, on the second Monday of each month, i.e. the day before Patch Tuesday, I suggest running two simple batch script files. One entails the WinSxS folder and the DISM tool, while the other the Windows directory itself and the SFC tool. Let's focus on the first. The WinSxS folder is the component store, that is indeed the collection of all OS components pieced together into packages. These are used to perform various critical functions, as installing and rolling back updates, turning features on and off, restoring the system from failures, repairing corrupted system files, and many more. The DISM tool helps to optimize and protect the ideal state of the component store via four commands. AnalyzeComponentStore reports whether there are obsolete packages that can be deleted and current components that can be compressed. And ScanHealth checks WinSxS against a non-good copy from Microsoft servers, I believe by comparing the hashes of their respective contents. If no cleanup is recommended and or no corruption is detected, you should close the CMD prompt. Otherwise, proceed with the next commands. StartComponentCleanup effectively carries out the removal of superseded packages and the compression of components. And RestoreHealth actually fixes WinSxS by replacing the damaged components with proper copies, downloaded from Microsoft servers. Just after the completion of this first script and before the execution of the second, it's good practice to go over the DISM.log file for further information, and then reboot the system. Now we move on to the second script file, which is more intelligible than the former. The SFC tool helps preserve the integrity of all protected system files thanks to a single parameter, ScanNow. Its operation is simple. First, it verifies the Windows directory against the known good component store. Then, if necessary, retrieves empty files from it, in order to replace broken ones. Once the work is complete, you should examine the cbs.log file and then restart the system again. In case you don't know how to create batch files, it's easy peasy. Copy-paste the commands from the video description to the notepad, save as .bat, right-click, and run them as administrator. Finally, a couple of concluding remarks. The DISM.bat must always be run prior to SFC.bat, or else the latter would use a possibly dirty WinSxS folder as a source of the replacement files, and would thus completely fail in achieving its purpose. Moreover, do not expect these scripts to magically resolve all your OS issues. As I've said at the beginning, they are more of a prevention than a fix. Many thanks for tuning in and fare you well for now.